powers have all these destructive weapons and delivery system. They know that they don't need huge armies to launch their attacks. All they need is a few men manning the consoles, and they can literally wipe out hundreds of thousands of even of people or millions of people, devastate whole countries and render them no longer habitable. They have this capacity, they have this power, but they are still researching, developing, testing and producing more and more lethal weapons, gleefully predicting their use in future wars. They cannot conceive of a world at peace. They believe that only they can be trusted with these weapons. The world need not fear them. They are reasonable people, caring people, whose respect for human lives cannot be questioned. But are they? They may not use the nuclear weapons and the other WMDs in their possession yet, but knowing that they have and knowing that no one would dare to attack them, they have shown their willingness to provoke weaker nations and to attack them with their so-called conventional but no less destructive weapons. They claim that their use of the power to kill people indiscriminately as making the world safe for democracy. They seem to think that only they as Democrats have a right to live, to be safe and secure. It is right and proper to make those who are not democratic unsafe and insecure. It is proper to kill other people in order to promote democracy. They fail to appreciate that the people who are not democratic are also people, are human beings whose right to live are no less than those who are democratic. The people who would be killed are innocent of any crimes against the democratic people, even if their leaders may be dictators. To deprive them of their rights to life must constitute a heinous crime, as the deprivation of the rights of life of innocent Democrats. Human right is not for democratic people only. Every human life is sacred. Every person has a right to live. Those who say that only Democrats have a right to live in security are no less authoritarian than the dictators the Democrats condemn. In fact, in many cases, authoritarian leaders or rulers have given their people a better life than some Democrats whose countries have been made unstable and insecure because of the weaknesses and uncertainties of the democratic system. What I'm saying is sacrilege, of course. But if we look at recent events, we would not fail to notice that it is the democratic countries which have been quick to use violence, who have violated international laws and shown disregard for the very human rights they so strongly advocated. It is they who resort to wars, to killing people, to achieve their national agenda. Truly, they are hypocrites. Irrespective of whether the warmongers are Democrats or not, we must regard war as a crime. No matter how just may the cause be, wars of aggression must still be regarded as crimes, crimes on a grand scale, for that is what war means. I'm aware that in struggling to make war a crime, we are calling for a radical change in the human mindset and value system. War had been with us since prehistoric time. Whenever human communities came into conflict with each other, they would resort to what we call war to resolve their conflicts. That is, they would kill each other so that one or the other of them would be defeated or cease to exist. The primitive people of the past knew no other way but to kill and exterminate their opponents. But today, we claim to be no longer primitive. We claim to be civilized. We look upon killings as a heinous crime. We want every country to uphold human rights and the rule of law. Besides, today the population of the world is 10 or more times bigger than the primitive populations of just a few centuries ago. Modern wars kill vast numbers of people. In the two world wars, 70 million people were killed. The number of seriously wounded and maimed for life is countless. And the devastation wrought is beyond imagination as whole cities are wiped out. In the wars of the past, battles were fought on battlefields. The people killed were largely soldiers who had been trained to kill and were equipped to defend themselves. Today, everyone, combatants and non-combatants, male or female, the old, the young, the children and the newborn, the sick and the incapacitated, all of them would be killed and wounded. They have no means to defend themselves. They may not seek shelter underground because diabolical new bombs have been designed to penetrate deep into the earth, to pierce concrete and to explode and destroy the shelter and all in it. Besides killing everyone, the whole country would be devastated, reduced to rubble. Water pipes, barrage and dams, power lines, and power generating plants would all be destroyed. Those who survived the bombs and the missiles would have no food and water, no electricity, no toilets, and no shelter of any kind. Disease would spread to decimate more of the survivors. Truly, modern war is total war, sparing nothing and no one. Our capacities for killing and destroying have passed the limit that the world and its population can bear. We are now capable of wiping out the whole human race and render this planet uninhabitable. Even if the war is limited, that is confined to a pair of countries or region, it will still be inhuman, as in most cases, the aggressors would have such superior capacities to kill and destroy that gross injustice would be done. The weaker countries would not be able to defend themselves. Frequently, they would be the only one to suffer while the aggressors continue to live in peace and security. And when the war ends with victory for the powerful, only the vanquished would be blamed and punished.